So since I've been sick, I got a lot of Instagram DMs of a lot of people suggesting different like remedies to me. One of them was this drink I'm making, which is apple cider vinegar, 2 tablespoons, cayenne pepper, and then usually a lemon and honey, but I don't have a lemon, I'm out, and I don't want to have honey because of the carbs, because I'm a few weeks out. I do have to say, the day that I started doing all this, I instantly started feeling better, and I'm also eating raw garlic, which is absolutely disgusting, so we'll start with that one. Okay, I'm a week out, and I smell like garlic, asparagus, echinacea, apple cider vinegar. For breakfast, I'm having steak and oatmeal, which I'm very excited about. We're doing like a practice pre-show day and show day, Friday and Saturday, so meal one is steak and oats. You're done with the morning plans?
Sorry? Oh no, I've got one. I've got two more.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know how many more I have.
Well, that one's going to be here any second. I'm going to run with the client.
Are you going to run with her?
Yeah, I'm just running with her.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Running buddy?
Yeah. She actually was a client before and then she retired.
So Emily, what is that right now?
It is my contract for the show. It's kind of a big deal to me.
You have to request contracts for each show that you do. So they mail you a contract and you have to sign it and date it. And then you are just like any other contract, like you have to do that show no matter what. And it's due tomorrow, so I'm sending it in today. That's what most pro competitors do, and then they'll release the official list of who all is competing, probably, I wanna say like maybe Monday or so, and that's gonna be like incredible to see, so I'm excited.
So I did my morning cardio session. I did 60 minutes on the stairmill. Probably the hardest session that I've pushed, like the highest level that I've done, everything. I wanted to quit like every single minute, and I wanted to press that stupid stop button and like, you know, cool down. Even like the last 5 minutes, I was like, you know, at 55, right in the 55 minutes, so I'll cool down on the treadmill. But it's like the second you press that stop button, you're pressing stop on all the opportunities that are gonna come after that. Like what happens if I do the 60 minutes? Is that gonna be what makes me win the show? Is that gonna be what brings the best package that I've ever brought, regardless of my placing? Like who knows? If I don't do it, I'm not gonna know, so I had to do it. And then I was gonna pose, and like something inside me told me to go sprint. So I went and sprinted, and I planned on doing 5 full out sprints. I did 5, and something in me, like, it's all cloudy out right now. I finished the 5, and then the sun like beams down on me. Sorry, I'm like 10 days out from my show. And it was like giving me strength. And I was like, I have strength 2 more, so I did 3 more. So, finished morning cardio. Sorry, I'm emotional. I'm gonna go pose. I gotta get my posing in, and then I'm gonna eat, rest for about 30 minutes, and then I have some work to do. I think I'm going to do... Oh man, this is worth everything I just did. Oats and peanut butter are two of my favorite things.
Emily, what's going on?
It's so good. I'm just doing a conditioning style workout, meaning circuit-based workout, higher intensity most of the time. I'm gonna probably incorporate a few sprints for cardio, and then I'll do cardio after. So just gonna do some circuits, knock it out, setting my timer for about 35 minutes. Gonna push really hard, and then I'll finish with cardio.
Just point yourself in the direction of your dreams. Find your strength in the sound.
I told her to be here this morning, and I'm still here. I'll text her maybe tomorrow or Saturday, maybe.
Perhaps.
I can get you guys to not sleep in on your off day. Now we just have to deal with life hard things, and that's fine. Everything really is bigger in Texas. Look at that, that's insane. Like, I'm gonna have to... Amazing. I don't want to use those for my carbs. I don't need to be in here, but these are really good. That's cute. I'm sitting here like kneading the bag. Like, oh, it's so good. Oh my god. Yes. So, what's funny is sometimes I crave a warm meal randomly, but I also really like my cold cod. So, like, I'm eating a warm and a cold.
You're eating two?
Yeah. I'm like behind on my protein.
Pretty awesome. So of course I want to do it again, because this time I just was doing it to complete it.
I'm excited. I'm gonna get three burgers in a row though. That's what's awesome about competing back to back, is every weekend I get to have a burger. I know you, Ben, and I know your voice, and I know you're not telling me the whole story, are you?
Don't start there.
So after the movie, I got to, you know, I got to take a little nap, and then I woke up and I had my most productive hours from about 8 p.m. until midnight, 1 a.m. So during that time, I was able to do a lot of emails, talk to a lot of my sponsors, touch base with my coach, booked another hotel, a rental car, you know, paid some bills, did some things I needed to do just for the business side of things. So right now, this close to my show, again, I'm just really listening to my body. I'm training really hard when I can. I'm always refueling, staying on top of my water, paying attention to when my energy levels are up and down. If they're down, I'm napping. If they're up, I'm working. So I'm very in tune with my body right now and it feels really good. So tomorrow I'll be leaving Houston. I'm going straight from Houston to New York. And so where I actually live is Venice, California, and I train at the West Coast Mecca. So tomorrow I'm flying to New York and I'm training at the East Coast Mecca. And that's where like everyone who is into bodybuilding, they train at that gym in New York. So I am gonna be using my peak week, which is the week leading up to my show day. I'll be using that week training at that gym, just pushing as hard as I can. It has the same kind of vibe as, you know, the West Coast Mecca, where everyone that's in there, they're very, very serious about what they're doing. I've already been in contact with other IFBB bikini pro, like friends of mine that are doing the show, and they're doing the same thing. So we're already planning on meeting up for cardio and pushing each other, and yeah, we'll be next to each other on stage, and we're even gonna pose together at the in the posing room, you know, but it's one of those things where you're so focused on yourself, and you know as a pro athlete that you deserve to be up there just as much as anyone else. So, you know, to us, we look at it as how can we help each other? How can we push each other, empower each other? And so we're not threatened by each other whatsoever. If anything, it helps to have someone else that knows what you're going through. So I think it's gonna be a really great week of just very focused training. I'll be staying at a hotel close to the gym and staying by myself, which is really good for me because it gives me that ability just to kind of close off, you know, take a deep breath and just focus and do what I know I need to do. So I'm really looking forward to that week, which is not what you typically hear about a peak week, but I'm excited for it. It's gonna be just what I need before the show. I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for coming into my life for a day, my life when I'm here in Houston. It's been an absolute blast. I hope you guys enjoyed it, maybe learned something. I know it's a little intense. That's how competitors are, the, you know, being 9 days out from my show, 8 days out. I'm a little more intense than normal, so just know that this is a competitor's view on what's going on right now in my life. It would be very different come like improvement season or something. So you guys should comment down below, let me know what your favorite part about the day was, and I'll see you guys next time, hopefully. Bye.